Hola, buenas noches a todos. ¿Me escuchan? ¿Aló? ¿Me escuchan? Hello, hello.
Sí, señor.
Regáleme dos, tres minuticos. Empezamos, esperamos a que llegue más gente y iniciamos, ¿les parece? Dos o tres minuticos. ¿Listo?
Bueno, sí, señor.
Hola, buenas noches a todos, ¿me escuchan? Voy a compartir pantalla y iniciamos, ¿les parece? Listo, ya, creo que ya estamos. ¿Sí pueden observar la pantalla? Por favor, ¿me confirman? ¿Aló? Hello.
Sí, señor. Muchas gracias. Se ve.
Ok. So, hello, everyone. Donde aprendemos la cámara para presentarme. Ok. Hello, everyone. My name is Jorge Amado, and today we are going to talk about worldwide celebrations. Ok. This is our laboratory for today. Today is December the 2nd. It is 6:07. And let's gonna start. So, first of all, if we want to talk about worldwide celebration, we have to take it into account that around the world we have different traditions or different celebrations that are celebrated each year, okay? So today we're going to see some of them, right? So the idea with this kind of activity is that you can remember the date and what is the celebration for, okay? The day and the celebration for, okay? So let's gonna start. If you have any question, you can ask me whatever you want. I'm gonna be there to help you. You just need to raise your hand or you can interrupt me if you want, okay? So remember, my name is Jorge Amado and today I'm going to be with you all night, okay? The laboratory lasts like, let's say 60 to 70 minutes, I guess. So let's gonna start, okay? So let me continue. Okay, so let's gonna start with number one. Number one is Chinese New Year, okay? When is celebrated? It is celebrated in the first new moon or the new lunar year, and it could be either in January or February. So this one is like New Year's Eve, but I'm not sure what is it? When is it, right? It can be in January or in February, okay? Okay, so let's gonna continue. Okay, let's gonna go with this one. This one is the most common one. I think this one is the most popular. In Colombia, we have a different date, okay? But around the world, we have that February 14th is the Valentine's Day, okay? What is the date in Colombia? When is it in Colombia? Do you remember or do you know when is it? In Colombia, when is it?
Hi, teacher. I don't know.
It's September 20.
Yes, it's more or less September 20. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Now, let's gonna see what kind of things do the people do in Valentine's Day, okay? So on Valentine's Day, couples share their love to their partner, okay? In Colombia, I mean, for example, the English teacher, we have to celebrate it twice, right? We celebrate it on February and on September, but the normal people usually celebrate it just once, in September or in February. In Colombia, we have a special tradition that we play with our friends, that is the sacred friend. Have you ever played that kind of activity? El amigo secreto? That we usually have to give a special gift to a person that we, okay, a person choose randomly, okay? So for example, for me, I remember that the last one that I have to give to the person was about fruits because she was vegetarian and she doesn't like sweets. So I have to give her only fruits. I spent like 20,000 pesos on that. And I gave her like, I don't know, like say 20 different fruits. So let's gonna continue. Let's gonna continue with the other one. I don't know what is going on, but it's a little bit slow. Okay, this is not this one. Okay, this one. The St. Patrick's Day is celebrated on March 17 every year. So I have a question for you. Where is it celebrated? Where?
Ireland.
Thank you. Very good. Thank you. Yes, you are right. It's in Ireland. Okay. And what do people usually do? On St. Patrick's Day, people wear green clothes and drink green beer. Okay. That's what people usually do in St. Patrick's Day. Have you ever watched The Simpsons? The Simpsons have some of the chapters about the season are related to this kind of celebration, St. Patrick's Day. I remember that there was a chapter when Bart Simpson got drunk, you know, and it was a total disaster because, you know, he's just a kid. He can drink, okay? So, you know, this one is like one of the celebrations that I like it a lot because, you know, it is about drinking and wearing green clothes, okay? So let's gonna continue. April Fool's Day is celebrated on April 1st every year. I have a question for you. What do you think, or what is the translation of this word April Fool's Day? What do you think is that? April Fool's Day in Spanish. If you want, you can tell me in Spanish. What is it? What do you think is it? It is. The kids, No, it is not the kids. No. No.
El día de los tontos de abril.
Yes, el día de los tontos. Thank you. El día de los tontos. We have a similar one in Colombia, which is on November 28 or December 28. I can't remember what is it, but it is called El Día de los Inocentes. Yes, it's a similar one. You know, but I'm not sure the date. I'm not sure if it is on November 28 or on December 28. I'm not sure about it. Let's continue. Now, on April Fool's Day, people may play jokes on each other. You know, this one is similar to Día de los Inocentes. It's similar to that one. Okay, but it's like an American tradition. It is not very common in Colombia, but in the United States is very popular. Okay, so let's gonna continue. This one I think is the most important in all year, you know, because it's the Mother's Day. And the Mother's Day is celebrated on the second Sunday in May each year. Okay, so it can vary depending on the year. Sometimes it can be on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, we don't know. But it is about our moms, okay, our mommies. You wanna sound a little bit, I don't know, weird, let's say that word. And what do people usually do on Mother's Day? On Mother's Day, children show their mother they love her, okay? We usually write, I mean, it depends on your age, but when we were kids, we usually write a letter, right? Right now, no, we have to give like fancy gifts to them because they deserve it, you know? Because it's her special day, so we have to celebrate that we have our mom with us. So that's why we need to give up a good gift. Okay. So let's gonna continue. International Children's Day is celebrated on June 1st every year. Okay, that one is the International Children's Day. But what about Colombia? Where is it? When is it? In Colombia.
El Día de los Niños, pero aquí tenemos dos.
Which ones?
Uno en abril. Y el otro supuestamente el 31 de octubre, pero que es Halloween. Y lo metieron por la parte, digamos que negativa de los, no los disfraces, sino el significado. Entonces, comercialmente metieron el 31 de octubre también como Día de los Niños, pero es en abril, el 17, yes. Creo.
Yes, you are right. I mean, you know, the celebration, the majority of celebration are related to money. You know, that the people have the need to buy things for in order to celebrate that day. Christmas is a similar one, you know? And most of the celebration are related to money. Money. What about the next one? Father's Day is celebrated the third Sunday in June every year. This one is a different one, you know? I think this one is, I mean, this one was not very common, like, 5 or 10 years ago, it was not very common. This one is it's a new celebration. For me, it's a new celebration. I mean, for me, it's not very common. 5 years ago or 10 years ago, I didn't know that it was a Father's Day. It was like the El Día San Pedro, creo que le decían, algo así. But I don't know right now what is the name. The only thing that I know is that the Father's Day is in June, and that's it. Okay, so that's gonna continue. What do people usually do on Father's Day? On Father's Day, children show their father they love him. Okay, so we usually buy them things, I don't know, perfumes, clothes, jewelry, I don't know, an invitation. It depends on you, okay? Let's gonna continue. This one is the Independence Day for Canada. Okay. What about Colombia? What is the Independence
Day? July 20.
July 20. And for the United States?
4 July.
July 4, right? Yes, you are right. I think one of the most common movies about it is, I don't know how you ever watched this movie called The Independence Day with Will Smith.
Born in the 4 July.
Yes, that's another one.
It's
a good movie. I mean, I like the first one and the second one. Okay, they have like, you know, good special effects. And I think they're gonna make a new one, the third part. Okay. Yes, it's the Independence Day, the July 1st. And what is the day for the Independence Day, July 1st? What is the day when they declare the independence? July 1st, 1867, okay? It's gonna continue. As you can see here, we have the America's Independence Day, you know? The America's Independence Day on July 4th every year, you know? What do people usually do on the Independence Day? They usually, I don't know if it is expression or not, play with fireworks or something like that. They get together and make a barbecue sometimes, and they burn fireworks.
Military okay. parades?
Which one?
Military parades.
Ah, yes, you are right. That's a good one, you know, in order to celebrate that the Independence Day, okay? Let's gonna continue. The Mid-Autumn Festival is held on 15th day of the 8th month for the lunar calendar by the Chinese and Vietnamese people. Okay, el Festival de Otoño. Okay, when is it? It's on the 5th day of the 8th month. I mean, August 15th. Okay, depending on the calendar, right? And it is celebrated for Chinese and Vietnamese people. Okay. And the Mid-Autumn Festival also celebrates the end of the autumn harvest, okay? From September to October, depending on the date, okay? And the Mid-Autumn Festival is celebrated in September, October, depending on the full moon, you know? Es como cual es la celebración para terminar la cosecha, something like that. And this one is it's not very common because, you know, we are usually in contact with the American culture, but with the Chinese culture, I have an idea what is it, the National Day of China. But now I know, yeah, that is on October 1st every year. You know? The next one, let's gonna continue, okay? Yes. Chinese National Day celebrate the birth of the People's Republic of China on October 1st, okay? I think this one is one of the most popular around the world, okay? And it is Halloween. Have you ever wear a costume? I'm gonna send this out. No? Have you ever wear a costume? No? I remember that when I was a kid, my mother bought a costume. It was about an indigenous. Just give me 1 minute. Wait.
Hello.
Yes. Sorry, it was my cat. She wanted to go out, so I have to open her the door. Okay, yes, this one, Halloween. I remember that when I was a kid, my mother used to, I remember that I wore a costume, a Batman costume, a clown costume, and it was like, I can't remember, a Robin costume. I remember those three different costumes that I have to wear when I was a kid. The Batman, my friends, Adam, the Robin y de payaso. Those are the ones that I can remember. Esos son los que puedo recordar. Llega un tiempo en que ya uno no lo disfraza y le ponen simplemente una máscara. O Recuerdo también que me disfrazaron de indio, me pusieron un montón de plumas y fui a reclamar dulces y cuando llegué a la casa llegué en calzoncillos. Porque eso se cae. Y uno es niño. Entonces, okay, so, Halloween. Let's gonna continue. Halloween, vamos a terminar. The next one. What do people usually do on Halloween's, on Halloween date? On Halloween, children dress in costumes and trick or treat from house to house. Bueno, ahí le faltó la Eri, porque es trick or treat. ¿Qué significa trick or treat in Spanish?
What is dulce it? O truco.
Dulce o truco, yes, you are right. Dulce o truco. Usualmente uno salía con el tarrao, llegaba con el tarrao lleno, corriendo todo el barrio. Hoy en día, it's not very common. It's not very common because, you know, with the pandemic, we are losing some traditions. Estamos perdiendo algunas tradiciones con la pandemia. I don't know if you have noticed that, but we are losing some of them. Maybe we're gonna take them back, but we are not sure for that. Okay? Let's gonna continue. Okay, this one. American Thanksgiving is celebrated on 4th Thursday, November every year. Okay. Have you ever celebrate this kind of occasion? This celebration? For example, for me this year I did it. I was in Bucaramanga and it was with the English teacher from the institute. Yes, Acción de Gracias, that's the definition from English to Spanish. And it was pretty good. We usually eat like turkey, you know, or we usually eat, special food for that occasion, a special plate, and that's it. Let's gonna continue. Thanksgiving was first celebrated to give thanks for a successful harvest. Okay, let's gonna move. Now this one, Christmas. Christmas is celebrated on December 25 each year. Okay, there are thousands of movies about the origin of this kind of tradition. You know, I mean, there is one right now that is on Netflix, a new one that is about a boy that is trying to find something. I can't remember what is it because I haven't watched it before, but it's a really good one because I can see the trailer and it was really good. It's gonna continue. Okay, that's one of the tradition. Santa Claus comes to Christmas Eve, December 24. Okay. I remember that I used to believe in Santa Claus until I was like 10 years old. And I realized that the person that used to put the gifts in front of the tree was my mom. Not my father, my mom. I was a little bit disappointed, but you know, we have to grow. We have to grow. Okay. Let's gonna continue. Okay, yeah, this one. Santa leaves a present for the children to open on Christmas Day. Okay. And the last one. Is the New Year's Eve. It's celebrated around the world each year on December 31st, the last day of the year on the Gregorian calendar, okay? And that's it. As you can see here, we have all the information. We have all the days. We have the St. Patrick's Day, the Halloween Day, the Children's Day, the Independence Day from Canada, from the United States, the National Day of French China. You see, we have a lot of the information. Now we are going to try to remember that information because I would like that you pay special attention to some kind of words, that the ideas that you, at the end of the session, you will learn, okay? If you don't understand, you can tell me, teacher, you can speak slow or can you please speak in Spanish or 50-50 and I'm gonna do it, don't worry, okay? So let's gonna go to this one. Okay, so if you want to participate, you just need to turn on your microphone and let me know which is the correct answer. And we are running out of time. Okay, so what about number one? What do you think is the number one around the world? There, what is it? South languages. Dana, tell me what do you think is the answer?
R.
R. Okay, thank you. So around the world, there are many different holidays. These show the variety of cultures and what is it? Sports, traditions, artistic.
Traditions.
Thank you. Jorge, what about the next one? Traditions that we have. In Scotland, we, Jorge, what do you think about the next one, number three? In
we Scotland, have?
We have, yes, we have particular events that, what is it?
Well,
that
were
shared.
That were no, yes. Shared. That were shared past or in present.
Past.
Okay, shared. That shared similar aspects to some holidays in Colombia. The April Fool's Day that we have in our country and the April Fool's Day in Scotland since their inception. Oh, this one is a good one. What do you think?
Jokes.
Okay. The purpose of making jokes or jokes?
The purpose of making jokes.
Okay, and what about the one that we have here? What do you think? Think about it, take your time, breathe, and let me know what do you think is the answer. No.
Found.
Okay. Found the purpose of making jokes or deceiving others for fun. The Edinburgh Festival and the Barranquilla Carnival always. Think about it. We are not running. What do you think? No idea.
Soaked.
Okay, why not? Just gonna leave it like that. Don't worry. At the end, we're going to check it out a lot. Then, the next one. Are true. This one is easy. Languages, share, where, participants, artistic, or
where?
Through where? No, where not? It's not. It's not current one. What do you think?
Participants, maybe.
Participants, presentations. Okay, why not? They have succeeded. Finally.
Sports.
Sports play a very important role. A very important role in any country. For this reason, in Scotland, the Highland Games
were
presented. Thank you. Since 1040, likewise in Colombia, we are
chair.
No.
Artistic.
We are artistic in the national games. We are held every 4 years since 1928. This is how we are related, despite the geographical location, customs, traditions, and
language.
And languages, many countries share very similar holidays. Okay, do you want to change some of them? ¿Quieren cambiar alguno o están totalmente seguros? What do you think? Take your time and let me know. Tómate su tiempo y me lo dejan saber. Just like that? I think, for me, I think this one goes here. Art, true, artistic representation, and so forth. So artistic goes here, for me. Okay? That's for me, but this one, what is it? Artistic representation and so far. They have to say, finally, sports play an important role in any country. For this reason, in Scotland, the Highland Games were presented. Since 2014, like was in Colombia, we are.
Chair.
Which one?
Chair.
Shared. No, es que no concuerda porque tendría que ser en pasado. Porque yo, aparte de ver prácticamente el contexto, hay que mirar que la conjugación esté correcta. Y este tiempo no existe en inglés. We are sure or not. Existe con este. Okay. Creo que este debería ponerse acá abajo y ese de arriba. ¿Sí? Creería yo. Porque aquí ya está en pasado y si está en, la oración inicia en pasado, se entiende que este también va en pasado. Sí, pero eso es como un infinitivo. Creería Jonah. Many countries y participants acá. I don't know. No sé. Damos submit. Miramos.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, let's gonna see. Da, 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 da. ¿Cuánto nos quedaron mal? 5. Bueno, si no cuenta cuáles nos quedaron mal, miremos ahora a ver. Leaderboard, no, Stargate. Ok, la misma. So, number one, what is it? Around the world, there are many different holidays. These show the variety of cultures and
traditions.
And traditions. Okay. In Scotland, we
had.
No, ese have no está ahí. Porque ese fue que nos salió mal.
Sí, salió mal.
Creo que este have al final, creería yo, ¿no? Porque esta frente para mí nos quedó mal.
We were.
Bueno, pongámoslo, ¿por qué no? Events that
chair.
Este no va acá, entonces chair en pasado. Making jokes. Sports. No sé si no me ha quedado bien. We are. Artistic, no sé si artistic representation nos quedó bien, no recuerdo. Games.
Participants.
Con tres que nos queden mal, podemos pasar a la siguiente actividad. No hay problema. Y miramos las respuestas, obviamente no nos vamos a quedar con la duda. So, what is it? Found, shared, solved. ¿Qué significa solved? ¿Qué significa eso? Solved.
Como que fue buscado, como que se buscaba.
Exacto, es el participio de buscado, ¿cierto? Entonces, ¿podría ir acá?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Shared y found. Pensémoslo, pensémoslo. ¿Cuál creen que está mal y cuál creen?
Found and shared.
¿Van cambiadas? Okay.
Yes.
Okay, claro. Sí, porque estamos hablando acá, ¿no? Que comparten diferentes aspectos y uno los que el mismo día se celebra básicamente es el mismo día y comparten el propósito de hacer las bromas.
Yes, teacher.
Listo. Ok, ¿algún otro? ¿O lo dejamos así?
¿Así, profe?
No se preocupe, vamos a mirar y miramos detenidamente cuáles eran las respuestas correctas. ¿Listo? Miren, miremoslas bien. Entonces, acá no puede ir where. ¿Listo? Miremos. ¿Sí? ¿Cuál fue nuestro error básicamente? Nuestro error básicamente es en los verbos. ¿Se dan cuenta? Entonces, around the world, there are many different holidays. These show the variety of cultures and traditions that we have. Perfecto. In Scotland, we found particular events that have similar aspects to some holidays in Colombia. Claro, porque está haciendo la referencia de que en Scotland también hay eventos similares en Colombia, que son, se parecen. The April Fool's Day we have in our country and the April Fool's Day in Scotland since their inception shared en pasado, o sea, comparten. El propósito, okay, for making jokes of the saving art for fun. The animal festival and the carnival always sought to highlight art to artistic representation and so far. They have succeeded. Finally, sports play an important role, that sports perfecto. For this reason, the highlight games were presented. Esto es passive voice, were presented. Since 1014, likewise in Colombia, we are participants, o sea, somos participantes, in the national games that are held every 4 years, since 1928. This is how we realize that despite their geographical location, customs, tradition, and language, many countries share very similar holidays. This is incredible. ¿Listo? No se sientan mal. Estaba un poco complicado, pero sí nos faltó, ¿saben qué nos faltó? Fue memoria, porque pasamos de 5 a 7. Entonces, eso hay que intentar evitarlo. Ok, but don't worry. Don't worry. Let's gonna continue. Este nos va a reconfortar. Ok. Vamos a tomarlo por números. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Son del 1 al 20. Ok. Number one, no, 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 pero vamos a hacer todos, lo van diciendo. Okay. 119. Thank you. Good. The next one.
11 and 3.
11, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 3. Good. 13,
15.
Okay, again.
Teacher, 13, 15. No, teacher, 13.
Okay, let's gonna do something. Vamos a hacer algo, okay? Entonces, porque ya no hay números, ¿sí? Ya nos quitaron dos, entonces nos cambiaron prácticamente todo. Entonces, line one, van a decir line para la línea 1, línea 2 y línea 3 y un número. Entonces, line one, 7. Entonces, busco yo el número 7 acá, no está el 6, digamos. ¿Sí?
Line 3.
Okay. Line 3. Okay.
Line 3, 1,
Three. One. Okay, thank you. Very good. Nos estamos entendiendo. This one.
Otra, line one. Fits, la primera.
Fits, thank you.
No, la primera.
Pero no es la de days, no. Okay, the next one. What do you think?
Line one, fifth. Second line. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Four.
Four.
Sorry, it was my bad. Okay, the next one. No. We have
second line number 3 and last third line number 2.
Okay.
No, number one.
You say 2. Okay, this one. Okay. That's it. Okay, that was mine. What about the other ones? Let's search for this one. What do you think it is?
Line.
Last one, number one.
1, 2, or 3. Line 1, 1, 2, or 3.
Line 2.
Which one? 2, 3, or 4?
2.
4. No?
2.
2. Ah, sorry, these 2? Yes, thank you. You are right. Understand. 2, 3, 4, sorry. We have 3 more and we finish this part. What do you think is the answer?
One line. No, second line.
1 or 2?
2. Second line, 2.
Okay, thank you. And this one, which one? 1 line, 1 or 2, or 2? Third line.
Line 1, 2.
Yes, you are right. And that's it, we finish. You see? And if you have a look at them, you realize that each one of them represents a celebration, right? We have St. Valentine's Day, we have St. Patrick's Day, we have New Year's Eve. You see, we have like 10 different celebrations, okay? So let's gonna continue. Let's gonna move to this one, okay? So we are going to have a look to the picture and we are going to see what are they about. What kind of activity do you have to do in each one of them, okay? So what do you think? Oh wait, we can play in a different form. I think this one is much better. Yes. I think they're bigger. Yes, a little bit. We're going to have a special dinner. Which is the picture? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Give me a number.
3.
Okay. Thank you. The next one, going to dress up or wear a costume.
Second line number 2.
6.
Second line number 2. Yes. What is the celebration?
Halloween.
You see? Easy. Thank you. The next one. Going to buy a present for my father. Which one?
The last one?
Okay, yes. The next one. I'm going to make a card for her mother.
Second line first.
Thank you, very good. The next one. I'm going to pray to Jesus Christ. The first one. Yes, you are right. The next one, I'm going to go to a parade.
Line one, number two.
Yes. The Independence Day, remember? That is a celebration. We have Father's Day, Mother's Day, going to be seeing my family. What is it?
Line one, number two.
Line one, number two. Thank you. The next one, going to decorate the house. Where is it?
Second line.
The last one.
The last one in the second line. Yes, you are right. Yeah, that one is for Christmas. You know, the next one, going to give gifts.
Last one.
Christmas Eve, right? Christmas Eve. Okay. And the last one is this one. Going to match the fireworks. Going to match the fireworks. And that's it. We finish. Okay. Now, let's gonna continue. We are going to move to a more difficult part. We are going to close these activities. And we are going to go to this one. Okay. I'm going to share with you this activity. Se las voy a compartir a ustedes. Acá. Se las compartí por el chat. Y vamos a trabajarlas. ¿Qué vamos a hacer? Vamos a intentar ubicar esas palabritas acá. ¿Cómo se hacen? Tomándolas así de una a una. ¿Listo? Donde ustedes crean que va cada una de ellas. Donde ustedes crean que va cada una de ellas. Al final ustedes le dan finish y le dan submit y revisan si les quedaron bien o les quedaron mal. Nos quedaron mal porque sacamos cero. ¿Listo? Eso es lo que van a hacer. Les voy a dar, para que ustedes trabajen, les voy a dar 3 minuticos. Y ahorita lo hacemos entre todos. ¿Listo? 3 minuticos. Igual yo voy a estar acá pendiente, ¿no? Pero para que ustedes lo hagan por aparte, 3 minuticos, háganlo y ya retomamos esta parte para terminarla. ¿Listo? 3 minutos. ¿Ok? If you have any questions, any doubts, please let me know. ¿Ok? Preguntas o dudas, yo estoy aquí para ayudarles, me lo hacen saber. ¿Ok? ¿Ok? Entonces, por ejemplo, la primera. On New Year's Eve, people go to parties and drink a lot of. Entonces, toca buscar una bebida. Entonces, decorate, have, K, New Year, it's Merry, Manifest, Champagne. Sí, miramos si es champagne, digamos finalizar y revisamos. Sí, ven, eso es lo que tienen ustedes que hacer. Lo mismo que yo acabé de hacer. Pero no dale verificar de una vez, sino inténtenlo todas y al final le dan verificar y miran cuáles les quedaron bien y cuáles les quedaron mal. ¿Ok? 3 minutos. Cualquier duda, estoy acá pendiente.
Usted sí se ha demorado, Pachito.
Okay, so what about number one? Number one, on New Year's Eve, people go to parties. Yeah, let me turn to, okay, thank you. The next one, on New Year's Eve, people go to parties and drink a lot of champagne, right? The next one, the 1st of January is called, what is it? What is the answer? What do you think is the answer for number one, for number two, sorry. We have candles, Mother's Day, New Year's Day, invite, presents, eggs, Mary, Bunny, festival, New Year, decoration, celebrate, decorate it, have or cake. What do you think is the answer?
New Year's Day.
New Year's Day. Okay, thank you. The next one. My mother always bakes a chocolate. Which one?
Cake.
Cake. Thank you. With
candles
on it for my birthday. Yes. Thank you. The next one. What is it?
Have. Celebrate.
I have a birthday party and I. What is it? What is the answer?
Invite
all my friends. Invite. Thank you. At Christmas, we
celebrate.
We celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ. Okay, the next one. People put out a lot of
decoration.
Decoration for Christmas. The next one. They also give each other
presents.
Presents. Okay, the next one. I wish you a
Merry
Christmas and a happy
New Year.
Okay, the next one. Easter is the most important
festival
in the Christian calendar. Okay. The next one. In some countries, parents tell their children the Easter. What is it?
Bunny.
Okay, Bunny has hidden chocolate
eggs,
and they race to find them around the house or garden. In some places, children decorate or Mother's Day?
Decorate.
Thank you. Yes, decorate. And the last one. This one. In some places, people decorate hard-boiled eggs at Easter time by painting them. In Mother's Day, children traditionally please Mother's with flowers, cards, or gifts. Okay, let's gonna do it. 10 out of 10. Esta fue la reivindicación del anterior que hicimos, dice que no fue como regular, de 5 y pasamos a 7 después. You see, this one was easier than the previous one. Okay, and that's it. Now, we are going to finish with this one, okay? Vamos a terminar con esta actividad, ¿listo? Nuestra actividad del día de hoy. Muy increíble, bien, Claudia. Muy bien, esa es la idea. Okay, let's gonna continue with this one. Este básicamente es lo mismo, ¿listo? Estos son los festivales alrededor del mundo, lo mismo que hicimos ahorita. Entonces, ¿qué van a hacer ustedes? Van a leer, ¿sí? Van a observar la imagen y van a mirar el festival. Si se dan cuenta que son 16 y son 16 imágenes. Entonces tienen que unir la imagen con el festival. La imagen con el festival. La imagen con el festival. ¿Listo? ¿Listo? Entonces van a simplemente escribir el número. Por ejemplo, si se diría que el número 5, entonces ponen el número 5 ahí. Sé que es el número 4, ponen el número 4. ¿Sí? El número con la imagen. ¿Listo? Luego, ustedes van a unir el tipo de festival con la descripción. ¿Sí? Mira, así como yo lo hice. Ustedes cogen un lapicito y lo indican así. ¿Listo? ¿Ven? Así. Y lo mismo, les voy a dar 3 minutos para que intenten hacer lo que más puedan y ahorita lo hacemos entre todos. ¿Listo? 3 minuticos. Que ya se los compartí por el chat. Háganlo y ya lo revisamos. ¿Ok? Okay, so what do you think it is number one? You're gonna tell me the number, 1, 2, 3 from 16. So what do you think is number one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What do you think it is the answer? No? What do you think it is? No? Number one. Mardi Gras, Christmas, Halloween, Columbus Day, St. Patrick's Day, Independence Day, Mother's Day. What do you think? Thanksgiving, Easter, New Year's Day. Nine. Yes, you are right. It's nine. It's New Year. Sorry, it's Easter. Now, what about the second one? The second picture. What do you think it is?
13.
Valentine's Day. Yes, you are right. Thank you. Very good. Thanks for your participation. The next one. Picture number three, what do you think?
Five,
yes, St. Patrick's Day, St. Patrick's Day. The next one, number four, what do you think is the answer? No idea? Okay, number five, what do you think is number five?
Four.
Which one? Four, the Columbus Day.
Number four.
Four, okay, the next one. What do you think is this one?
Ten.
New Year's Day, okay, why not, ten. The next one. This picture. Two, Christmas, thank you, very good. The next one.
Sixteen.
May Day. Okay, why not? Screen 16 now, and we are going to check it out. This one.
Three.
Okay, three. Halloween. What about this one?
14.
14, which is the Father's Day. Okay. The next one, this one. Huh?
11.
11. April Fool's Day. Yes, why not? This one is the Mardi Gras, which is number one. This is the easy one. The next one. This one. I think it's 15. I'm not sure for that one, but I think it's 15. We have this one. What is it?
Eight.
Thanksgiving. The next one, Mom, is the Mother's Day, right? Number seven. And the last one, the Independence Day, which is six. Okay, and that's it. We have all of the, what about this one? What do you think is this one?
One teacher.
New Year's Eve.
One teacher.
New Year's Eve, right? 12. Entonces este sería la víspera de Año Nuevo y este sería New Year's Day and New Year's Eve. Esta es la víspera, ¿no? New Year's Eve, víspera de Año Nuevo. Y ese es el Año Nuevo. Okay. Okay, so let's gonna check it out. Vamos a revisar. Ok, bien. Este me quedó mal. 6, ¿por qué? 6 me quedó mal porque era el número...
Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving. Es que yo puse, era el 8 y puse el 6. Ese fue error mío. No sé si ese fue error mío porque sí, yo recuerdo que ustedes me lo dijeron. Sí. Don't worry. That was my mistake. Listo. Ahora, tenemos 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, tenemos 10 y tenemos 16. ¿Cuál de las 16 va en cada uno de ellos? Los voy a acercar un poco para que lo puedan ver mejor. Ahora sí. ¿Mejor?
No, de, no.
¿Sí ven mejor o no? ¿No se acercó?
Sí, sí, señor, sí, sí.
Ok, what about number one? People celebrate the arrival of spring by outdoor events on the first day of May. ¿Cuál sería?
May Day.
May Day, ¿cierto? De hecho, uno celebra es esto, ¿cómo se llama? El Día del Trabajo, ¿no? El primero de mayo, ¿no? En Colombia. Right? The next one, the official U.S. holiday that celebrates the nation's birth with fireworks, outdoor meals, flags, and speeches. Which one?
Independence Day?
Independence Day. Yes, you are right. The next one, a popular carnival in the United States held in New Orleans during the week before the first day of Lent. Where is it? Creo que es Mardi Gras. ¿Por qué me acuerdo de Mardi Gras? Porque menciona Nueva Orleans. Y yo sé que Nueva Orleans, el festival de Mardi Gras es en Nueva Orleans. Que empiezan a reponerle un montón de, ¿cómo se llama? De collares con pepas. Okay, de Mardi Gras, Nueva Orleans. Okay, the next one. The tradition giving cards of presents to fathers began in America in the 20th century. What is it?
Father's Day.
Father's Day, thank you. Father's Day, this one. Father's Day. Okay, the next one. The Day of Love and Romance.
Teacher, it's not Father's Day.
What is it?
Valentine's Day. It's in February.
No, but it's to fathers.
Ah, the second one, I'm sorry. The Day of Love and Romance in February.
And this one, the day of, okay, yes, it is Valentine's Day, so this one. Okay, the next one, the first day of the new year when people often make resolutions. Esa es como las resoluciones. Resoluciones es una palabra que se utiliza como para lo que usted quiera hacer el otro año. For example, next year, yes, exacto. This year I want to buy a house. This year I want to learn a new language. This year I want to... I don't know, I want to travel to the United States. Why
New
not?
Year's, New Year's Eve.
New Year's Eve. Okay, this one. New Year's Day. Sí, porque es el primer día. New Year's Eve es la víspera de año nuevo, o sea, es el 31. Okay. Es como la diferencia, creo. New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. The next one, the national in Ireland, when people celebrate the national saint of the country, traditional wearing a shamrock.
St. Patrick's Day. Number 5.
St. Patrick's Day. St. Patrick's Day. Yes, you are right. The next one. A special day in February when a small animal comes out of his hole after his winter sleep and sees his own shadow goes back down his hole. There will be 6 more weeks of winter.
Where is Groundhog it? Day. Groundhog Day.
And the last one. Sorry, the previous one. The next one, sorry. A night in the end of October when people once believed that ghosts could be seen, now it is time to have parties and play trick or treat.
Halloween.
Halloween, right? Halloween. And the last one, one of the most important holidays for many Americans, but remember the early days of pilgrims in America with the traditional dinner.
Thanksgiving Day.
Thanksgiving Day. You see? And that's it. So, mirar como nos fue. Finish. You see, all of them are right. Stop. Y ese era nuestro propósito del día de hoy, aprender de las diferentes celebraciones. Muchas de ellas ya las conocemos, muchas de ellas como nosotros estamos en contacto con la cultura americana, ¿sí? Muchas de ellas las conocemos. Sí, a pesar de que uno diga que no, uno habla mucho, las ven en muchas películas o en series. Como yo les contaba al principio, el día de San Patricio no lo ven los indios karatico. Sí, que todos se visten de verde. O en las películas, tiene que llegar vestido de verde porque no le pegan. O le pegan pellizcos. O cuando va, llegó a ese día y le pegaron pellizcos. Sí, hay muchos.
¿Dígame? El Groundhog es la marmota. Hay una película de Williams que él hizo sobre eso.
Groundhog Day. Thank you. Sí. Esa historia no me la sé muy bien, la marmota, pero sí se me hace conocida. Muy, muy bien, gracias por el aporte.
No sé, del 94, yo no creo que ustedes la hayan visto.
No, yo apenas voy iniciando tercer piso.
Profesor, ¿usted tiene link de asistencia?
No me lo dieron. Espéreme, porque según lo que yo sé, regálenme en un momento, ya les comento. Déjenme en un momento. Busco yo por acá la información de... Eso es de English Laboratory, ¿cierto? Es que creo que ustedes firmaban la asistencia o se registraban para asistir, ¿no? Registro y acceso. O sea, yo les voy a compartir pantalla para que ustedes vean. Tengo entendido que ustedes asistían, teniendo en cuenta que ustedes hacían el registro. ¿Ya hicieron este registro? Se les llegaba invitación y hacían el registro. Y les llegaba luego un enlace. Sí, entonces yo creo que ese es el registro y la asistencia para el día de hoy. Usualmente compartimos un Excel, pero no el día de hoy. ¿Sí? Simplemente con que ustedes han hecho el registro y como ustedes ya están ingresados acá, entonces ya con eso ya queda registrado todos. ¿Listo? Igual hoy no somos muchos. Pero igual recuerden que hay un montón de actividades que ustedes pueden participar, ¿no? De hecho, esta actividad hace parte de las actividades de inglés del mes de diciembre que están por acá. Espérenme, yo las veo por acá. Este no es... Creo que me lo enviaron esta mañana. ¿Dónde está? Prográmate. Míralo, aquí está. Este es. ¿Sí? Ustedes pueden asistir a todos estos. También tenemos otro. Describing different situations using conditionals. ¿Sí? Creo que la fecha está mal. Parece. Porque es el mismo día y usualmente lo dejan en un día diferente. Entonces, creo que es la próxima semana, el día martes, que sería como que el 7, creo yo. No estoy seguro. Y tenemos muchos eventos que ustedes pueden seguir participando. Esa es la idea, ¿no? Que ustedes siempre participen y que no dejen morir estos espacios, porque la idea de eso es que ustedes aprendan. Espero que hayan aprendido algo el día de hoy. Nos encontraremos en una próxima ocasión. Recuerden que mi nombre es Jorge Amado y para mí fue un gusto tenerlos en clase. Nos veremos.
Bye, teacher.
Que tengan un buen resto de noche.
Thank you very much.
Okay, you're welcome. Bye, bye.
Thank you, teacher, for your time. Bye.
Okay. Bye.